What is going on, my friends, and welcome back to another video on the channel. On today's video, we are going over Solana as we are in a very urgent moment, honestly. What we are looking at is the possibility of a really big bullish breakout or a really big bearish breakout. So I'm going to give you guys the things you cannot be ignoring over the next 24 hours as we do monitor the Solana price. So of course, in the last video, what we were talking about was going to be this formation here. So what it was looking like at the time was that we had some type of M top forming. Now what I said in that video was that we absolutely needed to hold our key level of support between $184 and $178. Now that video was just 2 days ago. Since then, what we can see is that the price held that level of support beautifully, came back up and looked to put in another high. The issue then becomes that we put in this high, a higher high than a lower high. And as many of you do know, if you're not too new to technical analysis, this is going to be just about as textbook of a head and shoulders pattern as you can get. Now, what we need to know about this is that this is generally speaking going to be a bearish pattern, meaning that if there is an execution of the breakout price, then we'll likely see the price break to the downside, okay? Now, what we need to be paying attention to at this point is, again, our key level between $184 and $178. Once we then came down and put in these lows that we saw here, that establishes this region as our shoulder line. Now, typically speaking, we will only really be looking at this level here. The reason we're going to consider this a region and also include these levels of support here to create this box is due to this previous level of resistance that we're going to go over later. So just to kind of clarify if there was any confusion. So what we're paying attention to right now is $184 to $178. At this point, if we are to lose $178 to the downside and get a close on the 4-hour charts below it, we can definitely be looking at a possible fall, a more gradual and continuous fall, back down towards roughly $151, which would result in a fall from the point in which we are at now, all the way down about 23 to 24%. So we need to be paying very close attention, and we absolutely cannot ignore $184 to $178. Now at the moment, it does seem as if we may be looking at some type of move to the upside. One of the reasons why I do say that is because if we look at the 4-hour MACD, we are actually looking at a possible bullish blue and orange crossing to the upside, which could entail that some more continuation of a greenish, you know, slash bull run could be continuing here, okay? But at the moment, we definitely need to pay close attention to this pattern, as if the price does fail to continue upwards and we fail to get that crossing down there, we definitely could look like a breakdown to the downside and then some fall to the bottom, okay, towards $150 again. Now, with that being said, do I think this is likely to happen? No, I don't think this is likely to happen, but it is very possible, okay? I'm going to always give you guys everything within the realm of possibilities. And so, of course, with that being said, let's talk about what we need to see in order for the price to see a move to the upside and invalidate this. Well, the biggest and I would say the most essential thing that we can see happening at the moment, you know, in the short term, is the crossing of this green line right here. Now, this green line is going to represent what we are looking to establish as our right shoulder. That's going to be at $204. The best case scenario right now in this exact moment is that we are actually able to go up and clear this level here. Now, one thing you may be able to notice is that if this is the case, and if we're able to work our way back up towards these levels, what we could be looking at is, instead of a head and shoulders, by establishing a new higher high here, we may be looking at a left shoulder, a head, and a right shoulder on an inverse head and shoulders. Now, just like a head and shoulders is bearish, an inverse head and shoulders is bullish. And once we are able to clear this level here, that is going to be the breaking of our previously established shoulder line, which says that there definitely can be a more extensive move to the upside. So right now, we can go ahead and say that whichever one of these levels we clear first indicates if we're going to see a large breakout to the upside or a large breakout to the downside. Now, one thing we can see is that on the daily charts, we are also looking at some type of possible formation of a W bottom. Now, when we have these W bottoms, it's not uncommon that once we run into the top of our, you know, the left side of our W, as you can see there, in which we run into a bit of resistance, have a retracement and a continuation upwards. Sometimes those look a bit like these cup and handle patterns, or they just look like a W plus a reestablishment of support, continuation, of course, whichever way you want to look at it. But on the daily charts, if we are able to come up and clear this line, we would very likely be able to reestablish, you know, some support on top of these key levels. And with such a strong possible bullish pattern forming on the daily charts, that goes to tell me that we definitely can be looking at some type of extensive move to the upside if we do get this break of about $204 and we hold that level. So pay very, very, very close attention to these levels. Pay attention to 204 and pay attention to 178. Whichever one of those we clear first is going to have a major indication on where the price goes over the short and the midterm. And I think there can be some very explosive moves thereafter. So with that being said, of course, I will update you guys as soon as anything does happen. And if we see any of these massive breakouts to the upside or the downside, you will be the first one to know. All you have to do is subscribe to the channel and turn on all notifications so you never miss a video. But with that being said, of course, those of you who do want to take advantage of these trades, of these gains that we've been seeing on the channel, all of the moves, the calls, and everything like that, go down to the link in the description. It'll bring you over to the Patreon, in which I'm fully transparent about everything I do on YouTube, as well as everything I do as an investor. And if you are looking to take part in these trades and you're outside the United States, looking for an exchange with super high volume and very extremely low fees, go to the link in the comment section. It'll bring you over to ByBit, in which you can sign up and win $25, as well as the possibility to win another $500. But with that being said, again, I will see you all very soon. Y'all have an absolutely amazing day. Peace.